Hello friends, welcome back to our biology class. Today we are going to start second chapter, the fundamental unit of life. So what is the fundamental unit of life? Cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So cell is the fundamental unit of life. So as to build a building, we need number of bricks. In the same way, to build an organism, we need number of cells. So as brick is the basic structural and functional unit of the building, in the same way, cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms. So cell, from cell to tissue, a group of cells will make a tissue. A group of tissue will make an organ, and many organs will combine to form an organ system, and many organ systems will be there in an organism. So cell is a basic structural and functional unit of all organisms. So today I'm going to give the introduction of this chapter. So let us see how the different these theories are given by different scientists. Today we are going to see about all the biologists. So Robert Hooke, in the year 1665, first he observed dead cells in the cork. And in 1674, Leeuwenhoek, he discovered the free living cells in pond water. And in 1831, Robert Brown, he has discovered nucleus in the cell. So nucleus is an important part of the cell. It is the brain of the cell. It plays a major role in the cell. It performs many important characteristics, or many important role, we can say. So that we are going to study afterwards. And in 1839, Purkunje, he has coined the term protoplasm. Skeadon in 1838 and Schwann in 1839, they proposed cell theory. And Rudolf Virchow in 1855 explained cell theory and said all cells arise from pre-existing cells. So now let us see what is the cell theory. So cell theory is all living cells, all living organisms are made up of one or more cells. The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of all living organisms, and all cells arise from pre-existing cells. And when we talk about the shape of the cell, the shape of the cell may be fixed or may not be fixed. It is fixed in some cells, like parenchyma cells, it is having the oval shape, so it is having a fixed shape. And it is not fixed, that is example amoeba, it is shapeless, it can take any shape, shapeless. So here I have given you points to note down: not fixed, example amoeba, and fixed, example parenchyma cells, that is having the oval shape. And when we talk about the size of the cells, the size of the cell can be very small and it can be very large also. And size of the cell, like it is very small, like the smallest size of the cell is mycoplasma, and the largest size of the cell, here you can see ostrich egg, it is the largest cell. And the longest cell in the human body, it is there, that is the nerve cell, it can be up to 1 meter long also, it is the longest cell. So today we have seen all the introduction about the cell. And in the next class, I am going to explain you in detail about all this. Thank you so much.